Hi. Our charging modules are great. I use these TP4056 based modules extensively. They have always worked well. Until last week. Look at the beautiful work. What happened? Simple. I left these batteries charging for 2 weeks, and boom. If you value your life and don't want fires to break out in your home, you better keep watching the video. In the meantime, support me by following my channel. If you find the artificial voice in the video disgusting, you'll learn how to remove it forever. About 5 or 6 years ago, I built this thing that I also showed in a previous video. As I mentioned, I left two 18,650 batteries charging for about 2 weeks. As soon as I realized this, I saw that the batteries were very hot. I immediately turned off the power and tried to remove them. As soon as I touched the first one, it burst into flames and exploded, resulting in this. I was very scared and immediately bought a fire extinguisher. If you play with these old, crappy batteries, buy it now. I was stupid to forget to charge the batteries all this time, but after looking at the datasheet for the 4056, I realized that I could have avoided the explosion for just a few cents. Before I continue, remember that I have a Ko-fi account. As soon as I receive 100 donations, I will remove this fake voice and use my own. Don't be shy, give me all your money fast. The TP4056 is the brain and heart of the modules we use so much. I have talked about it extensively in the past. According to the datasheet, the TP4056 has a pin called temp, usually pin 1 of the chip, that is used to monitor battery temperature via an NTC thermistor. If the temperature is too low or too high, the chip stops charging. This function is not used in these modules, so the temp pin is directly connected to ground. With the most advanced technology, I can show you everything more clearly. Let's take the most widely used liquid in the world after water, and then an octopus. All we need now is a brand new phone. Let me introduce you to my new professional microscope. As you can see, there are two different modules. In both cases, the temp pin is the one closest to the dot on the IC, so it's easy to recognize. In both cases, we have to cut the track of the temp pin. Right here. And here, too. Excellent. Now, we need to connect the thermistor to the circuit. Here is the circuit from the datasheet. I simplified the circuit like this. As you can see, we only need two resistors and the thermistor. I will use a 10 kilo ohm NTC thermistor. R1 and R2 are simply a voltage divider connected to the thermistor. The TP4056 only considers temperatures to be valid if the voltage at the temp pin is between 45% and 80% of the input voltage. In my case, the input voltage is 5 volts. I would like the temperature range to be between 5 and 45 degrees Celsius. According to this formula, you need a 4.87 kilo ohm R1 resistor and an 86.6 kilo ohm R2 resistor. Unfortunately, I couldn't find resistors with these exact values, so I rounded them to 4.8 kilo ohm and 88 kilo ohm. Here is the result. The 10 kilo ohm NTC thermistor consists of R1, which is made up of a 4.7 kilo ohm resistor and a 100 ohm resistor, and R2, which is made up of a 68 kilo ohm resistor and a 20 kilo ohm resistor. Of course, we also have the positive and negative poles and the cable connected to the temp pin. Soldering this last cable is difficult, but it can be done with a little luck. Now that the circuit is ready, all that's left to do is pray and test it. I power the module with 5 volts and zoom in to get a better look at the module's LED. After a few seconds of holding the soldering iron close to the sensor. Magic! The module stops charging. Wow, it seems to be working. Let's see what happens with these frozen beans. Boom!
Whoa.
It works even in the cold. While I celebrate that everything worked the first time, I wanted to share a few small conclusions with you. First, be careful with used batteries. As we've seen, they can be dangerous. If you don't want to spend a lot of money, at least take all the necessary precautions or buy a timer for 4 euros. I wanted to share this project with you because it could have prevented the mess. In my case, it didn't cause any damage to people or property, but it could have. Thank you for following me this far. Please subscribe, check out the links in the description, and, above all, give me all your money now because I'm nice and unemployed. Hugs to all.